Hello, everybody. Thank you for listening to me. My name is Marco Pelitteri, Professor Lee, who is the chair of this panel, has probably already introduced me. I will go directly to give you a short talk about my work in progress, an embryo of a possible research path, or at least of a book chapter. So you will have to forgive maybe the sketchiness of my talk. I will speak for not more than 15 minutes, considering that I am not part of the Q&A. Therefore, I will take a few more minutes, but I will try to stay, of course, around 10 minutes. So I am a mass media sociologist. My main field of specialization is actually visual communication, design, and popular culture. However, I am also working on the relationship between representations of certain countries in the media, in the global media and national media or regional media, and elements such as soft power and, in general, cultural diplomacy and global or regional reputation. So now I will minimize my the screen with my face, and I will put it here, and I will privilege the PowerPoint, and I will try to go as quickly and smoothly as possible. So the title is of this short talk is Italy's lockdown, public communication, and the role of global image and aesthetics in the international media performance during the first anti-pandemic lockdown in Italy was February March 2020. So the topic and scope of this talk is not specifically about China, but with Professor Lee, we also thought that as an Italian, I could give a specific contribution from another perspective. So I hope this will not look and sound off topic, but as a complement or supplement to the interesting discourses that I know you are conducting or will be conducting also after my talk. So the background of this talk can be summarized in 4 points. I did a quick analysis of the communicative situation in the nexus between science, politics, infotainment, and institutional communication in Italy, of course, elicited by the situation that started to occur from the end of January. And second, the contents, priorities, and styles vis-a-vis the political situation in Italy and internationally in January and May. The role of Italy's global image and particular cultural position as a highly peculiar with respect to many other countries. Of course, we can say that each country is special in its own way, but I will try to show that certain shared elements in the imagery and the common grounds in the terms of knowledge about Italy and narratives about Italy has played a relevant role. And I will show you some very conflictual, contradictory images portraying the lockdown in China and the lockdown in Italy. And a collateral aspect that I have analyzed more deeply in other related talks is the unexpected unifying role of the Prime Minister in Italy, Giuseppe Conte. I don't have so much time to go deep about his role, but I will show you a few slides that should put everything into context. This is just a few quick hints about the guiding concepts that will stay for reasons of time really in the background, even more in the background, upon which I am informing my ongoing work in this specific subject of discussion. Goffman, Moscovici, the notion of confirmation bias, peculiar idea about soft power, which is not the soft power specifically as it was theorized by Joseph Nye, but in some development, some evolution that, because soft power is not the same for all countries, and not just the quality of soft power, but also the origin and the way it can be used. But also the political philosophy of the state-people relationship, we can notice that in the way Italy has stepped up in the international stage during the lockdown, has specific characteristics if compared with other countries in Europe, such as in particular the United Kingdom, but also others such as Sweden, where the characteristics of this state-people relationship were very different, and also therefore the measures to prevent or to protect or to limit the damage were very, very different. So a quick slide about the media situation in Italy in February, so last winter and then spring. I will just focus on the fact that 80% of the population in Italy gathered official information from the government through social media and not through the official sources. So there is a situation that we can define divided, and where the information is highly, strongly biased by lower use of official sources of information if compared with other European countries of the core group of the strongest economies. So I want to raise your attention on a few elements. The institutional communication by the government during the lockdown was focusing on this sentence, this hashtag, andrà tutto bene, which means everything is gonna be all right, which originated specifically from Italy in March, and then expanded in various forms all across Europe and even in the United States. But originally, this sentence originated in Italy. There is a video that I will show, of which I will show you just a few seconds. So this is one of the many initiatives, like in so many other countries. But let's see if I can go to the other slash, so the other is a slide. Another interesting hashtag slogan was Io resto a casa, which means I stay home. And this is in a way similar to what was communicated in other countries. But what I would like to stress here is that in a country where the population is typically not so keen to listen to ordinances, orders, and dispositions from authorities, I stay home is not a commandment from outside, but a suggestion that in theory, ideally, starts from each of us. So it's not a disciplinary rule, but it's a suggestion that in theory, every citizen should internalize. I will move on. Well, I will show you this imaginary, this one of the spots, TV commercial, TV videos from the government. Il mondo ci sta aspettando. Says the world is waiting for us. Siamo distanti adesso. Let's keep distances now to stay again closer very soon. Io resto a casa. So I stay home. So there is a certain symbolism and rhetorics about these two sentences, but I wanted also to raise attention on the visual symbolism that we saw, especially in the second video, where you know, the part of the best of Italy, what people around the world know about Italy, appreciate about the country as a special place in terms of culture and art, and that classic typically attracts not just tourists, but also the sympathies of many people abroad. And this is a cultural capital that becomes a special form of soft power, as I said before, that has hardly, you know, similar or cases with the same intensities around the world. So very few words about the current prime minister in Italy, who exceptionally incarnates, embodies an idea of institutionality, of elegance and serious attitude that is very rare in recent generations and cycles of Italian politics. And so he's international credibility contrasts very much with the general low credibility of Italian politicians. But there was also something more that I want to show you finally. Let's sketchily define it, a relationship between soft power and aesthetics. And I want to summarize it as the role of the narratives and visual representations of nations in the international media as key factors in communicating the effort, the struggle, the national character of a nation vis-a-vis the pandemic. And here I have to be, you know, I want to be friendly and delicate. And what I want to show you is not a comparison in which somebody is nice and something else is not nice. What I want to stress is the bias of the international media, actually, because when in January, February, well, in February, BBC, one of the most authoritative news service in the world, or at least in the Western world, mentioned and covered this heartwarming news about many Chinese in Wuhan and in other cities who were shouting and singing from the balconies of their buildings. The news had, visually speaking, in terms of visual communication, a certain tone, and also the headlines were emphasizing the shouting rather than the singing. But when the same thing happened in Italy, the tone of the communication was very different. Italians were not shouting, Italians were singing, but the events were exactly the same. So why this different treatment? Again, residents in Xinjiang were yelling from balconies, and you don't see people in this in the first images chosen as still images in the news coverage. You see images from outside, from very far, and this is also maybe a problem related to the possibility or the non-possibility by international reporters to maybe well, in that case, it was also because everything was in lockdown. But very different visually and in terms of imagery and therefore imagination was the way the same thing was covered about Italy. Only Italians should sing on balconies, as these other nations prove. This is, of course, a very colorful kind of editorial that shows a very evident bias in favor of Italy and against other nations. And this is also part of the problem, of course. Of course, as an Italian, this thing may, in a way, cuddle me, but that's not the point. I want to raise a different point because the imagery that Italy shows was that even though the situation was very serious, this is what was happening. You can see nice images of nice buildings of Italian cultural heritage. Italians find a moment of joy in this moment of anxiety, which is part of the issues I was saying, because the struggle of Chinese people was not covered with the same tone. And in international communication and in the way China and other countries dialogue in this and the other occasion needs a serious revision. So Anne Applebaum on The Atlantic wrote that epidemics reveal the truth about the societies they hit. But I would also say that epidemics have revealed the truth about the way media cover those societies. And on this note, I will skip the other elements that I don't have time to cover. I want to thank you for your endurance or attention. And for those who are interested, can contact me later. You have my email address, or you can check my page on the website of Shan Jiao Tong Liverpool University. These are the sources, and I will close my recording here. Thank you very much.